Victor Nygren here. I'm playing Total War 1942, a mod for Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. It's been a while since the last episode. I'm playing as the German Reich, or the Third Reich in this game. And currently we are moving all the troops to the Eastern Front to fight the Soviet Union. We have already retreated from Africa and given the areas of Tunis and Benghazi to the Italian Empire and Mussolini, but the British have since taken Benghazi and the United States took Tunis, so the African regions are lost to the Eastern Allies. But we are still holding on to France, and Italy has the entirety of Italy. Then of course the Italians also have areas here in Albania, and we've given the Turks Athens and the area of Crete here, and we gave, I believe, Belgrade to Bulgaria, if I'm not wrong, and we gave this area to the Italian Zagreb. So all the armies are moving towards the east. I find out that I made a mistake when I played this game before. Usually after a battle you would click on the M button when you return to the map, because M is short for merge, so that would automatically merge all the units. So for example, if you have a bunch of infantry units and they are damaged after the battle, for example if you have 20, 30, 40, etc., and then you click M, which means merge, then they would combine and you would restore your units but lose some of the heavily damaged units. That's usually how you play in Medieval 2 and in Rome Total War, but it doesn't work well with the tanks and the planes, because tanks and planes are only like 3 in a battle when they are at the full force, while they are like 23 or something, 24 maybe, when they are on the map. That means if a plane unit is has like 10 left, 3 left and 20, then if you merge them, then you will restore your units to full health on the map. But you, after a battle, if let's say if you have an army of planes and after a battle each unit have lost one plane, which means maybe 5 or so in the number here, or maybe even 10, then if you click merge, they will combine with the others, and you will lose half the army, because in the battle they are only 3, but on the map they are 24, and that means that you will basically delete half your army when you click on the merge button, because I won the first battle with the new army that had many planes, but then I click merge and half the army, or half the 11 units of planes disappeared, and instead I got about 6 planes with full numbers when I after the battle had about 11 with weakened numbers. But I believe that if a plane unit has like over 10 in number, then it's still 2 at least in the battle, but if you combine it, then you restore it to 3, but we lose an entire unit that might have consisted of 2. So what I'm saying is one shouldn't use the merge function or the M button on the map after battles if you have damaged tanks or planes in the army, because planes and tanks, they are cavalry elephants, and for some reason elephant units doesn't work well with that function. You will lose half your units if you merge them. So I have, even though I had almost 0 losses during the battle, I still lost them all when I merged them, or lost half of them. You can see here I have about 7. I had at least twice that number before I merged them, and they may have restored the number to 24 here, but it's better to have, like, for example, this unit has 3, that's at least one plane, but I believe if it's 10 or something, then it's at least 2, so by merging you are practically deleting planes. So from now on I will not use the merge function when I have planes or tanks in the army. So, because that was a big mistake, I pretty much deleted half of my new air force. I still managed to win 3 battles in a row, even though I had only half the planes left. So they are still very strong. But from now on, we won't use the merge button. Alright. Then I have already moved this time. I think we have already built as well. Yes, so I believe it's time to just click next turn. We will do that. And speed up the process. So our German diplomat, Alfred von Kutschler, he reached the area in control by Portugal. Greetings, what did your Wirt offer us today? Alright, we will use the total diplomacy. It will enable us to force this faction to accept our offer. But because they aren't an ally, we won't force more than map information and trade rights. That's all we want from Portugal. And we are attacked this location. Soviet Union is attacking, and according to the balance of power, we are equal in strength. Army strength ratio 1-1, so we are very equal. They have 2 armies, but we have a very strong army with planes, even though we lost half our planes and instead had to fill it up with these riflemen. I believe all of these riflemen used to be plane and trice. When I merged the planes, all of them disappeared. I had to send riflemen here, and they are way worse. But even with only half the planes left, I still believe that they are very strong, so we might still win this. Let's take a look at their army. They have many T-34 tanks, they have some generals bodyguard with riflemen. That means they are starting generals. This was Dmitry Ivanov, Arseniy Ivanov, let's take a look at him as well. So he too were a starting general with a rifleman bodyguard, and then were Kirill Ivanov, so all of them are named Ivanov, and he had a rifleman bodyguard as well. All of them were starting generals from that wall of armies. Then here we have Leonid Petrov again, and Alexander Petrov. We have defeated them previously. So this army consists of, five units of riflemen, one already damaged unit of Katyushas. So we have defeated this army before, and they only had one assault infantry unit here, one guy left. All right, and they had 18 Yak 9 planes. This army were a defeated army, a remnant army. This army, on the other hand, seemed to be untried, but the infantry here seemed to have been in battle. I believe the tanks are fresh too. The T-34 tanks. So they are a medium tank, we will fight the battle, I believe. Let's save first, because it could crash after the battle if we're unlucky, or before the battle. And then we need to replay it, and I don't like replaying more than the actual battle. Alright, let's start to fight the battle on the battle map then. The 2nd Marine Division has been especially chosen by the High Command for the assault on Tarawa. What you do there will set a standard for all future operations in the Central Pacific area. Major General Julian C. Smith, commander of the U.S. 2nd Marine Division, November 1943. Good, the battle started. For that Reich indeed. All right. The medieval two German voices, they fit perfectly for Rome Total War, Total War 1942 mod. They fit perfectly for Germany, but I don't believe they were made for Nazi Germany. They were made for the medieval Holy Roman Empire, but as they are saying Reich, it fit very well for this faction as well. I just don't believe that that the voice actors expected this mod to show up with those with that sound. Anyway, it fit like the hand in the glove. All right. Yeah, but they are saying Mein Kaiser, they are not saying Mein Führer, so that shows that it's made for Medieval 2 and not for this mod. But we are using it for this mod because we thought it fit. Alright, so we have some anti-air trucks here. Weird, they don't have any guns. That might be because I merged the unit. I found out that if I merge units with tanks and cars and planes, then the tanks and the cars might actually lose their turrets or anti-aircraft guns. So I should never merge tanks or the cars after battles, but unfortunately I've already done so when it comes to this army and the other armies that have been in battle. So from now on we won't merge any units with tanks, cars or planes in them. But when it comes to the older armies that are already fielded, so to speak, it's already too late. I've already used that button. Alright, and as for the planes, we will have them under AI control because they are hard to manage. I still like how they move around and fight and such. It looks very good, but they are hard to manage. You can click on them, but you need to pause and click on the shadow under them. That's where you click to select them. But even if you select them, they are kind of hard to control. So that's why I prefer having them under AI control. But when it comes to the jeeps, the infantry and the tanks and cars, we could actually try to use them. The other problem is that the armies are so vast that they stretch almost the entire battlefield, so it's hard to, you know, have an overview over everything. So that's why I prefer having them under AI control. In all the other battles I let the AI control, but I realized that it's more fun to watch me play if I am manually controlling them. I could try, but the risk is that the enemy will win, because in Rome Total War the AI is pretty smart, and yeah, unlike in Medieval 2 I don't feel that convinced that I will win, especially not in Total War 1942. But we could try, and if I lose we will let the AI control the next battle. Alright, let's group all the infantry and assault the infantry into one group. That's a rifleman as well. Sniper unit could we could use in that group too. Had another plane unit there. And then we have the rest. Alright, start the battle. Pause the battle. So we have the enemy. Other side. I'm going the wrong way. Is it here's the enemy, the Soviet Union. Hit all their tanks. Look at the long row here of troops, and this is one army. That's why it's so hard to get an overview, because there are so many. That also makes it more epic to watch the AI fight while I do the tactical decisions in on the strat map, but let the AI fight in the battles. However, I will try to fight without the AI then, but the planes will be under AI control. Right, let's see if they have any planes here. And I'd want the planes to focus on their planes. They are probably in the other army that is arriving from the other side. Yeah, they are. They need to enter the battlefield. Jack 9 planes. Alright. The infantry. They will attack their infantry. Actually, don't need to send that many against that few. 12. All of the others were almost full size. Scout snipers versus scout snipers. That actually makes sense. The assault infantry, 20 of the assault infantry against the 13 riflemen there. You don't need to send anything against 2 assault infantry units. 147 riflemen. Yeah, full unit of German infantry have less numbers than the full unit of the USSR riflemen. They have 147 here, we have only 80. Alright, we'll send the 80 German riflemen against the 147. So they are more numerous than we. Oh, they have 193 here. Actually, they will be sent against that unit in the back instead. Alright, the infantry has been ordered. Our planes have also been ordered to attack. I could actually try to control them myself. Alright, we will select the planes. Let's attack a tank unit there. And another one. We'll do this for all the planes. They will attack the tanks. Each unit of tanks with the planes. We had as many plane units as they had tanks in their first army. And our anti-air squadrons could attack their infantry as well. As could our BMV motorcycles. And of course our Stokes mortars will fire at them. Alright! Well, the armored officer's car or jeep will stay behind. Let's unpause the game. They have a second army as well that will enter the battlefield, but we will try to attack the first one. Their army are moving forward. Let's see how it will do. They've ordered every unit to attack, with the exception of the bodyguard. Let's move the bodyguard forward as well. They don't have any guns because I merged them. The infantry running towards the enemy here. Infantry against infantry, planes against tanks. It'll be interesting to see how it proceeds, if I will be easily defeated. Shit, the tanks easily took out the already damaged trucks there, and the aircraft trucks. So their medium tanks are firing their medium shells towards our troops. Some BMW motorcycles driving there. Our infantry has now reached a position where they can fire at the enemy infantry. So they are firing now. But the enemy infantry are getting back up from the tanks there, the T-34 tanks. Even more T-34 tanks here. I want my planes to do something. Where are my planes? Alright, my planes are back here. I need to order them to attack again. Or maybe they are attacking the tanks like they were ordered. From a safe distance. They have a very long distance with their projectiles. We had some Stukas and some Messerschmitt 109 planes, mostly Stukas, but four Messerschmitts and four Messerschmitts and four Stukas, I think. Yeah, four of each. An equal number. The infantry are already scared away by the T-34 tanks there. Our planes are firing at them. Let's see how we will handle this. Oh, their planes have arrived there. I don't like that at all. That's a Stuka. I don't need a Stuka to fight their fighter plane. However, I do like my Messerschmitt there to attack the air fighter plane. The Yak-9 plane! Attack the Yak-9 plane! Alright, so the Messerschmitt 109 planes are ordered to change focus to their planes. While the others will continue to fire on the tanks. They have some Yakusha, some rocket trucks there. I don't like that. Send some Stukas against that unit. Hope they will bomb them now.
Gott schütze uns! Unser General liegt tot auf dem Schlachtfeld. Ohne ihn könnten seine Männer den Mut und die Schlacht verlieren.
Bombs are flying all over the place. They seem to win on the ground. We only almost only had bad infantry here, some motorcycles and a jeep. The jeep is gone, the general is dead. Heroic death. Gerd von Rundstedt. No, it was the known general. He won 3 battles in a row. So he died because I didn't focus on the ground. Had I let the army be controlled by the AI, then I wouldn't have lost him. Because the AI is pretty good at this, despite the changes of it being like modern warfare now, so it's harder than if it was like, for example, Lord of the Rings with medieval stuff. I'm used to that, but Total War 1942 is a different beast, so it's harder to manage all the units at once, especially on huge size. It's supposed to be played on medium, I believe, but I like the huge size. Now I try to manually control them. But the Soviet Union easily took control over the ground fighting here. But we took out the T-34 tank there. Good job, Stuka bomber. Alright, we need to use our planes to take out their tanks. Stand still. It's hard to click on the tanks too when they move, so I need to pause to do that. So we have some infantry here. Let's just place them under AI control, I don't care. But the planes I will try to manage. How is it going over here? You're bombing the troops. Seem to bomb them, but they seem to be focusing on infantry. No, they are actually bombing the tanks. That's very good. A lot of their T-34 tanks have been taken out. The infantry is unimportant. It's more important to take out all their mechanized stuff. So, order the Messerschmitt 109s to take out these tanks there. Do they have any more armor? Because That's what I'm worried about. They seem to have lost all their armor here. Good. Send all the planes against the tanks. All the planes attack the tanks. Stuka as well. They seem to be trying to bomb that tank unit there. Stukas are already attacking it. Good. It was taken out. We have more tanks here. It got taken out as well. So it's not impossible to control the planes. They just fly around, so it'll take you some time until they reach the enemy. They don't fly straight to it. They will easily take out the infantry now, and the tanks are out of the way. So we have most of our infantry routed already. We have three units still in the battle. It's ordered AI to focus on the infantry there. Well, our Stuka bombers are still bombing at their infantry. Soviet infantry are numerous, but they can't do much against our planes. Oh, they have a plane unit here. So it's time for our planes to focus on their plane instead of on the infantry. Take out the Yak 9 plane. Shoot it from this out of the sky. They have two planes versus planes here. Messmith 09 fighters versus their Yak 9s. Good. The Wurtless infantry could be AI controlled. I will try to control the planes and the tanks in future battles and any other mechanized stuff. Not the infantry. I might order them to attack from the start, but then I will place them under AI control like I did in this battle if they are not winning and if they have started to rout and such. Fighter planes here are having a field day against their infantry on the ground. And the balance of power have finally shifted. It's a shame that I lost the general. He was a known general who had won three battles in a row. Units routed, Stuka unit is routed. Enemy general fallen, Dmitry Ivanov is finally dead. Unit rout, Stuka, two units of Stuka have routed. Stokes mortar have routed. And a rifleman unit. Another two that I managed to pick, and a general died, probably one of the Soviet generals there. We only had one, so in this battle, and he is already dead. Alright, so they have some infantry left. How is the battle going against the Yak 9 planes? They are still in the sky. They have two planes in the sky. I don't want the battle to be that equal. I want all the planes to go there. They might even have three planes in the sky. Alright, we will speed up the battle. One plane went down. I believe it's a Yak 9 that went down. Enemy general fallen. Kirill Ivanov is dead. And another enemy general, Arseniy Ivanov, is dead as well. Unit routes, a rifleman unit is routed. And we seem to have won here. I can't see one of their planes. Rifleman unit fled the battlefield. We have won in the skies. That's very good. And yeah, seems the battle is pretty much over. statistics at 5%, enemies killed, 53% allies killed. I could exit the battle now because they are 85% killed. I believe that's enough to not have any of their units survive. If you play in Medieval 2, I don't know about Rome, but I think it's the same. Alright, do they have anything more? Maybe some riflemen somewhere. Feels good that I actually won, even though I managed this army myself and didn't place the heavy stuff under AI control. Their infantry are fleeing the battlefield. They are also tactically retreating some of their infantry. And we won. Continue the battle. Alexander Petro, users are dead. USSR, the United Soviet Socialist Republics, the real name of the Soviet Union. Alright, so we have won here now. Just waiting on the battle to be over. We lost a few of the planes. Now I won't merge the units after the battle. We need to build more planes and more tanks. But I will focus on tanks actually. Be more true to history. The Germans need an army of Panzer IVs, Panzer I's and Tiger I's to move to the east. I will focus on tanks before I return to the plains. It will also make the game more challenging. Because tanks are good, but as you know, the Soviet Union have lots of good tanks as well. They also have planes, but I believe that if we focus on tanks, we will have a harder time because they had a lot of tanks from the start. Even though we have defeated many of their armies now, but they have many left, I think. So we will focus more on tanks and then return to planes later in the campaign. Now I'm just waiting on the battle to be over here. And it's over! Battle results, clear victory. Your army, Gerd von Rundstedt, men deployed 742, he killed 1230, so he killed about twice as many as the number he had. Men remaining 354, so we lost more than half of our troops. Enemy armies, Kirill Ivanov of the Soviet Union had 770 men, slightly more than us, killed 342, men remaining 84, but they had a lot of infantry as well. Half the army were infantry and then the other half tanks. And tanks are, as I said, weaker than planes. Alexander Petrov had some planes, but way too few to handle our numbers. And Alexander Petrov had 665 in total number, and he killed 50, 111 left. Show battle statistics screen. Here's the detailed statistics. Right. The enemy must be annihilated before he reaches our main battlefield. We must stop him in the water, destroying all his equipment while it is still afloat. Field Marshal Erwin Rommel, 22nd April 1944. Yeah, didn't crash, that's very good. Another battle. So we are controlling one unit of Stuka fighters, and the enemy has rifleman unit, an assault infantry unit, and two units of scout snipers, and one tank unit of T-34 tanks. So the Stuka bomber should be able to handle that, I think. We will save. Fight the battle. secured peace for our country for 1.5 years, as well as an opportunity of preparing our forces for defense if faces Germany risk attacking our country in defiance of the pact. This was a definite night gain to our country and a loss to faces Germany. Start deployment. And that was Josef Stalin speaking. I didn't get to read everything because the loading was too fast here, because we had so few units in the battle that the loading went very fast or very quick. So we have a unit of Stuka bombers, tactical bombers of Nazi Germany. Then they have one tank unit and the rest are infantry. Let's start the battle. Where are their army? They are over there. So I need their tanks. These tanks are glitched. They've probably been merged. Or they are remnants of a defeated army. We've sent our Stuka bombers there to bomb the remnant tanks there. The only threat to the planes. They took down one of them. They can still fire even if they don't have their turrets. Now we are bombing them. Took down another one of the Stukas. So who will win? Will we be able to take down all their tanks? Will they take down our bombers first? They took down the almost the last one. Second last, alright. Fuck, they took down all of them. The tanks managed to win. So we lost the battle. Battle results, clear defeat. We killed 2 tanks, alright. This war is a new kind of war. It is warfare in terms of every continent, every island, every sea, every air lane in the world. Franklin D. Roosevelt, 23rd February 1942. That's unfortunate that they can actually take out the planes. We have no chance here. Withdraw from the battle. Auto-resolve, clear defeat. War declared on ally by Bulgaria on Hungary. So Bulgaria has attacked Hungary and we need to choose side. War has been declared. Alright, whether we offer them our support should be a matter of the gravest concern. Should we support the attackers? Bulgaria were loyal to us, while the Hungarians weren't. However, we have a border to the Hungarians. I don't want to have a war with any one of them, and I didn't want to break the lines either. Bulgaria and Hungary. Should we support the attackers? Actually, yes, they stayed loyal while Hungary betrayed us in the past. End of turn report. So we have 7012 in profits. That's pretty good. Heroic death, Gerdwald von Rundstedt, family member, that was very bad. Recruitment report. We have new Stuka tactical bombers in many cities and Messerschmitt 109 planes. I focused a lot on planes. We will change focus to the tanks for now, or panzers, as they were known in Germany. The following factions are now at war with each other. Bulgaria has declared war on Hungary and we took Bulgaria's side. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. Romania have declared a ceasefire with Turkey. Alright, that's alright. Turkey is a neutral faction. Alliance in tatters. Hungary and the Third Reich. Yes. Alright, we have another big force here, another Konstantin Petrov Soviet force. Trukov, the remnant army, and Grigory Petrov with a strong force, and some remnants there, more remnants, and the biggest army here that we saw in the beginning. Alright, so the Soviet Union is far from defeated on this front. Here we have a general, Walter Graf. He will not merge troops anymore. We might actually attack. Send the army there. So Minsk is held by the Soviet Union. Remnant army here. We will merge infantry by moving them like this. That's how I did it in the past, before I learned how to merge them automatically using the M button. But that can't be done now due to the tanks and planes. So that's it. We have merged the infantry and we won't do it to the planes. So these units, the army here, will move back. It's too weak to be there. Brest is still held by the Soviet Union. We move back to our front. This army need a new general, as Gerd von Rundstedt died. So we have Gottfried Gehlen taking command over the army now. And another unit of infantry retreated from the now rebel-held Riga, because there were a revolt in Riga. And we will send some new troops to the army. One Stokes mortar unit and one Messerschmitt 109 fighter unit, fighter plane unit, and some more infantry. Don't care, we will send everything there. Let's see, we need to merge the riflemen. Those units could be merged as well. We have some assault rifles here too, only one. We could merge the mortars, but maybe we shouldn't merge mortars either. I'm not sure. We got a bigger crew now, but I'm not sure about mortars. They are artillery, they aren't elephants. So it's okay, I guess. Here we have another army. Alright, this army could actually move there. So we have room for one unit there. I think we will send an assault infantry unit. Do we have 23 assault infantry? Combine with this unit. We send another one. 35 assault infantry. So, and that's their army for now, because we can't move their troops. And so their infantry here. We have quite a few assault infantry troops there. Let's merge the scouts. Scout snipers, yeah. And we didn't have more than one Waffen SS infantry unit. We had one more. Right. That's it for that army. Let's send a plane there as well. And if it can move, yeah, we will immediately move it towards the front against these. We will play that battle in real time, I believe, otherwise we risk having too many losses. So we have Erwin Rommel here. He will ignore neutral Hungary for now. And instead move Erwin Rommel up towards the front. He'll go using the road here. And then we had Gunter Alterbung. He will also move up that way. We had a new army building up here with many, with mostly infantry. Felix Battle, family member. And another infantry army there. Send the planes here. And immediately move him here. Alright, we have another road there. In case Hungary wants to attack, or if the Soviet Union would come from that front. They have some armies moving up there towards the east. Some planes here. Could try to reinforce this army under Felix Battle later. Vienna is held by a general with a jeep bodyguard and some infantry. In Prague we have infantry. Stettin we have a new plane. Alright, this unit could probably move some of their stuff out. Some assault infantry or something. Let's see. We will move one of the infantry units out. Had full sizes on every unit here. Right, we will let's move an SS unit towards the army under Ferdinand von Bock and send the plane to that army. Messerschmitt 109 plane unit there. And that's about it there. Do we have here in Oslo? Move the assault infantry to the ships there. We have room for two more. Move the ships. And the riflemen will move back to Oslo. While the assault infantry could actually be moved. Good. So we have filled up this army, now I'm just worried the British will attack it the next turn. They have a huge fleet here. We have quite a fleet too, but I'm not sure we would win. So I may have done a mistake moving it to the entire way to Oslo, because these waters are not safe. We are safe on this side. So we will see if we are getting attacked the next time. And if they will sink the fleet or not if we lose. Then I will lose the entire army of assault infantry troops there. We have one unit of riflemen as well. Hope that won't happen, but it could happen. Alright. And alright, we have some armies moving there. Berlin, we have a new Stuka bomber. Ready to be unleashed. Let's have, we don't have any room here. We're already sending a unit there. SS infantry, it's moving there, I think about it. Full army is there. Up some infantry to war, so two there, maybe we should have three. Send three infantry units to war, so I like having four riflemen in every city. Maybe with the exception of maybe the real German cities like Berlin, they won't revolt. Hamburg we have planes as well. We don't need to move them. Could use them to defend. One plane in each city is actually good. Even though we don't have planes in every city. Here we have another plane. Send it to, I believe, Vienna, the frontier. Scare away the Hungarians. Alright, right, let's see if we can use the spy. Female here. Let's see. Want to know how the front is looking. They have some towers here. Have some areas over there. Maybe we won't really move them away further. Now we have quite a view there. So we have a diplomat here. No, it's a Spanish state diplomat. And outside of... Yeah, we should talk to the British diplomat that used to be here, Hungary. Seems to have moved. That wasn't good. I wanted to speak to the British diplomat, but I forgot about it. It used to be a British diplomat here. Bulgaria is building up a fleet. They have an army there too. Another boy on QSL Xevano. Bulgarians are related to the Russians when it comes to their history, I believe. They were very friendly towards the Soviet Union. Turks are still fighting the Italians. So the British diplomat had moved, so we couldn't get the map information that I wanted from them. We already got the map information from Portugal. Here we have a French state which right, we can't do more there. Let's take a look at the agents section. Finland, we have Felix von Kachler, but Helsinki is conquered by Soviet Union, so we have moved all of our diplomats and the spy. Then it's time to look at the recruitment. Let's start in Berlin and the buildings. So in Berlin, Wied Kaserne will enable us to recruit Waffen SS. And in the heavy tank factory, we will get the Tiger 1. I think it's time to build that. I want the Tiger 1, I want to start to focus on tanks. We'll start building another, constructing another Panzer 4. That's what we'll do in Berlin. Hamburg, we will build another Panzer 1, I want a new tank army. Couldn't build any buildings there. Let's only do buildings for now. In Oslo we can't build anything, same in München. Frankfurt, we could build a large concern, SS headquarters, or the aerodrome. Weird that we haven't made the SS available from the SS headquarters, and instead in the concern, maybe that will be changed. Because we can only get spies from the SS headquarters, and the aerodrome, U-88, Stuka Messerschmitt, so we can get the big U-88 bombers there. I will focus on the large concern for now. I feel we should have that first. In Amsterdam, let's build a large concern there as well. And in Brussels and Paris we are already constructing stuff. Rouen too, Bordeaux, in Warsaw. Next turn they will be finished with a lot of buildings. In Vienna we can't construct anything. Same in Prague, Stettin, Copenhagen, and we are back in Berlin. Now it's time to look at the troops. So we are constructing a Panzer IV in Berlin, a Panzer I in Hamburg. In Oslo we will continue to recruit the Assault Infantry. In München we will now get a Panzer IV. We need an army of good tanks. And then we will construct another Panzer IV in Frankfurt. In Amsterdam we can't construct any tanks, we will go for a Stuka tactical bomber there. And in Brussels we'll go for Messerschmitt 109 fighter. In Paris we could actually go for the Stokes mortar artillery. And in Rouen we will get another Stuka tactical bomber for now. Bordeaux will get another Messerschmitt 109 fighter. In Warsaw we'll get a Stuka tactical bomber, they're good for defense. In Vienna we'll also get a assault infantry. In Prague we could get a plane, but I will go for the Panzer IV this time. And in Stettin we will also go for the Panzer IV. They're slightly better than the TZ4 tanks. And the Panzer I is slightly weaker. Copenhagen, alright, an assault infantry there, we had no other choice. And we're done. So we are done. Now I need to move the fleet. I believe it's on its way here. You can see the American army in Africa here. It's not a problem currently. Fortunately they won't hopefully attack with their fleet. And they would need to move all the way around like this, go through Turkey. They can use the ships, but the AI rarely do that. But they do that more often than in Medieval 2, so it's still a possibility, but I hope that will not happen too soon. Alright, we are done there. I need to fight some battles before clicking next turn. So we have a battle here. They have only few units, but I want that to be resolved on the battlefield. Because if you have to resolve it, I will have more losses than if I play it on the battlefield. So we will play it on the battlefield. Let's fight the battle on the battle map. As a result of the call, the machine guns were no longer able to fire. The result of all this was a panic. The battle worthiness of our infantry is at an end. General Heinz Guderian, November 1941. And that general has already died in this campaign. Start deployment. So our army is ready on the battlefield. Mostly infantry. Mostly assault infantry actually. That's pretty good though. And some scout snipers and two riflemen, that's very good. And they have 2 units of Stuka tactical bombers and 5 units of Messerschmitt 109 planes. Obviously the planes are the best units here. And then we have a jeep bodyguard, an armored officer's car. I will try to keep the general out of harm's way this time. I don't want him to die like Gerd von Rundstedt did. And as for the infantry, let's group them to one group and the planes into another and start the battle. So I just place the infantry under AI control. Then I will try to use the planes strategically on manually. Alright, the Stuka tactical bombers are best against the tanks. Of course we're gonna send them against the tanks. I don't know if they have more than one of the tank units. Let's start it so we can see the rest of the troops there. Now all of them have spawned. We have some snipers. Let's send both the Stukas against the tanks and then the infantry against their infantry. So let's start the battle. Stukas have been ordered to bomb their T-34 tanks. Hopefully they won't be shot down. These tanks are broken. So they will drop their bombs now on their tanks. That's very good. They also bombed some of their infantry. Some bombs are flying everywhere here. Oh, one of the Stuka planes got taken down. Kill those tanks. That's your main goal here. Not the infantry. So their infantry are already broken. One of the tanks got taken down there. Some of the others have also gotten taken down. Yeah, they only have infantry now. Perfect! Well done, Stukas. So we have won against their mechanized troops, and now we are terrorizing their infantry on the ground there. Very good. They're being bombed, and then our infantry are moving up, I hope. Yeah, they are moving, but they are not very fast. We'll get there too late. We lost another Stuka fire bomber. They are doing a good job bombing the enemy. Alright. The battle will be over very soon. 74% enemies killed, 1% allies killed. Captain Semyon. The captain, no one cares about the captain. Alright. Because captains are assigned into every battle. They aren't real generals or leaders. They aren't regarded as important for morale either. If you kill the captain, the morale won't be affected. But if you kill a general, then they will break in many cases. So the captains, they are worthless. They have some snipers. I don't care about AI, I just want my infantry to focus. And my planes, I'll send all the planes there now. Everyone has been ordered to attack that sniper unit, with the exception of the armored officer's car. They should be under heavy fire soon. Here comes the fighter planes of the Luftwaffe, and we have won, but I will continue the battle. We killed all of them thanks to the fighter planes, the Messerschmitt 109 fighters, and this is a great victory. Clear victory! Ferdinand von Bach, 544 men deployed. Kill 140, 534 remaining, that's very good. Captain Semyon, 140 men, killed 9, but they took out some of our Stukas, and 0 remaining. Throw battle status decks, and return to the map. You're nothing, your people is everything. Adolf Hitler in Reden, Skriften, Anordnungen, February 1925. This January 1933. Right. Some German there, probably. Yeah. I won't merge them, I almost did. I need to keep that in mind. Never merge an army when you have planes there. Instead, merge all the infantry units manually. Because otherwise, you will lose half the. Of the planes. Alright. Some snipers can be merged there. And some Waffen SS can be merged. And that's it. forward. Let's move it towards, order it to move the next time towards Brest, held by Ivan Konev and Georgi Ivanov. It's quite a force there. So very smaller victory there. Then we have a large army here, and they have a remnant army. We will attack there as well, save the battle. And we will fight the battle on the battle map. The defeat of the enemy in the Battle of El Alamein, the pursuit of his beaten army, and the final capture of Tripoli has all been accomplished in 3 months. This is probably without parallel in history. Lieutenant General Bernard Montgomery, 23rd January 1943. This was very, very bad weather. Let's wait. Ah, now it's much better. For das Reich indeed. Now we have the great army ready to fight here. With the cool looking Panzer IV tanks here, the forefront, and even some airplanes of the Luftwaffe. It's great that we have replaced all the most of the Panzer I tanks. Here we have some older Panzer I's as well. We have some BMW motorcycles, they are usually in every army. They use machine guns, of course. We have an artillery unit, the Vesp as well, and some Stokes mortars. No armored officer guard, we have 2 Vesp units. Alright. Let's group our planes into one army. I believe the fighter planes will be one group and the bombers one. Alright, we have 2 Stuka bombers and 5 Messerschmitt 109 fighters. As for the tanks, we can group them all into one army. I used to have twice as many planes. We have 5, 6, 7. I used to have about 11, I think, and then I had 8 tank units, but because I merged them, I ended up with 4. Because that's what happened, so I will never do that again, but we have 2 Panzer I's and 2 Panzer IV's instead of instead of 4 of each, like I had before I merged them. We have 2 riflemen, 1 sniper and 1 SS, alright. Actually we could move the infantry into 1 army. And then we have 2 artillery units, will be one group. Stokes mortar could be part of that group as well. It's an artillery unit, and then we have 1 BMW motorcycle unit and 1 Jeep bodyguard. Jeep bodyguard should of course be behind everyone. Let's move it back. Alright, start the battle. 1 army versus 1 army here. Quite vast. Army. And we have the Soviet army. The roads are no longer modern because we are probably inside of Poland now, fighting, or inside of Ukraine. Probably Ukraine, and they didn't have as evolved roads. Alright, so we have the Soviet army here. We ordered the tanks to attack their tanks. Our Panzer IVs will attack their T-34s there. Then another one will attack that unit. Then we have the Panzer I's, they are disadvantaged, but I believe they could still do well. As you see, I think it was this one they attacked, just to be sure. Oh, I clicked the wrong button. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4. We will attack this one. The 4th army. We will of course use Stuka tactical bombers against the rest here. Then we'll send some fighter planes to help as well against the tanks. To increase the chance of us winning and decrease the chance of them taking down our Stukas. As I didn't like when that happened. So, and then the artillery, they can actually be put on fire at will from the start. And then the Stokes the BMW motorcycles could attack their infantry. And the general will not do anything for now. Don't care about most of their infantry though. So they are moving their tanks to the front. Our Stuka bombers are already upon them. And the fighter planes should be as well. Here they come. Planes are sent in first in a blitz there. Tanks are driving back now. Being shot down by our fighters and bombers there. The infantry are mostly being ignored in favor of the tanks, because the infantry will be easy to take care of after the blitz with the planes worked. Our BMW motorcycles have also started to kill their infantry, the only unit ordered to take care of infantry. Moving them over and shooting them down with the machine guns. They don't have a machine gunner, I see that now. So that's what happens to the BMW motorcycles after battles. If we merge them, or if they have fuel left, I believe we merge, that's why it happened. Our planes did a very good job here. Now I know how to use them. We will split with the bombers and the fighters, then we will have the tanks come after. Continue battle. So the Luftwaffe took care of the armor, and then the tanks come in from the behind and are helping with the infantry, while the BMW motorcycles are also driving them over, because they lack the actual gunners. Their infantry are running away. 77% enemies killed. Their leader's dead. This battle went very well. Very well. It was blitzed. Tanks didn't even need to do anything, they just took care of the remaining infantry. The planes took care of all the armor on their own. So that's good for us. Alright, Panzer IVs are pretty badass looking, but the Tiger I's will be even more badass. I look forward to having them in the army. That's why we will focus on the tanks and not the planes. I know that the planes are better, but to be more true to history, we need to focus on the panzers. And maybe finish the buildings for the infantry as well, and do the planes last. So we will stop focusing on planes and start focusing on panzers. The infantry didn't do much. Battle is over and we won. Clear victory! Your army under Walter Graf, or Graf. Men deployed 509, killed 729, that's good. Men remaining 497. Enemy army under Konstantin Petrov had 826 men, killed 10, 94 remaining. Alright, and here is the detailed statistics. And return. Wingate was an absolute born genius with a mystical fire about him. Earl Mountbatten of Burma speaking after the death of Brigadier Order Wingate, March 1944. Good, it didn't crash. Enemy army routes, Walter Graf. That's good for us. I will not merge the troops, I will merge the infantry, but they didn't have any losses, I see. We only used tanks and planes, pretty much, and the planes did everything on their own. Can't move this time. They will be ordered to move towards the other armies there. And I believe we are done here. So, we will click next turn. No one attacked us. That's very good. I was afraid the British would attack our fleet here. I won't dare that. We have a full force here now. Shit, a Soviet Union fleet there. Clear victory! That's good. Towards the front consists the full army of infantry, mostly the better infantry, the assault infantry. Right, end of turn report. We are minus 5,348. That's not good. We are not minus here. We are 55,972, so that's good, but we are minus in profits. Faction announcements. Retinue expands. Gunther Alterbung. Retinue expands. Walter Graf. Yeah, because they won the battles. Wilderness Prophet plus 1 influence. Wilderness Prophet plus 1 influence. For both of them then. A construction report. In Rouen we have a small tank factory. We can make the Panzer 1s from Rouen now. Maybe the Panzer 4, but at least the Panzer 1. In Paris we have a big park. And in Brussels we have a small tank factory. In Bordeaux we have a small tank factory. And in Warsaw we have a small tank factory. Good. So Panzer 1s are now available in more places. In Vienna we have assault infantry, in Copenhagen we have assault infantry, and in Oslo we have assault infantry. Alright. And alliance in tatters. India and the United States of America have broken their alliance. Probably because India has attacked the British Empire, or the British Commonwealth of Nations as they are known in this game. And the US chose the side of the British over the Indian. So that's it. We have our spy here. I think it will be kept there. The Soviet Union have moved their armies past our army here. They try to move past it. Have another great army here. I think we will move this army towards that army. They will face off against this army during later part of this turn. We had some planes here, 3 units, and some tanks, but mostly infantry. They have a high chance of winning that battle. Will still be interesting. They had 3 units of Jak 9 planes. And I believe we could move the spy. Now we can see more clearly what is happening here. So this army is trapped in the territory here of either Kiev or Minsk, while the other armies are in the Warsaw region. These are going to move out of it. Full army under Gottfried Galen there. Is this a full army or is it just 3 units? 3 units. This is also a remnant army. Move an SS unit into this force here. And it will... Do they have an army there? town. We have lots of infantry here. I'd like to attack those places with something else. Infantry and planes. Here we had some mechanized stuff as well. Romulus army, I want to use that on the field actually. Move Rommel towards Riga. We will take Riga back. And then we will move Gottfried Galen towards Brest here. We had some Stokes mortars we can attack. Maintain siege. Here I have another army. I don't want to risk my general. He will not be in use there for now. We will probably attack Brest this turn. And let this army be controlled by AI. While we are using this army. Another army there. Let's move him up. Felix Battle. Move the infantry here to Warsaw. Then we have a plane unit. We are about to reinforce that army. Send it in pursuit of that army. We have a plane unit here as well. So we had a unit there. Send another plane unit there, Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. Then we had another army. We could send it this way towards the Soviets. And then we will wait with attacking. We move the general back to Warsaw for now. Move the ships next. Our own front. Portugal has an fleet there. The U-boat fleet will be moved towards our homeland. Right, and the troop ships there. We have a diplomat here. I want to speak to someone I haven't spoken to, but I'm not sure if there is any such diplomat here. Yeah, we have the French, no one there we could speak to. And down here, I know there were a British diplomat somewhere. That's an Italian diplomat. And yeah, we can't do any more now. We can attack. But I will recruit and build stuff first. We are still constructing stuff and building stuff in Berlin. In Hamburg. We can... we are building Panzer I tanks there. We're constructing. Let's see if we can build any buildings anywhere. Yeah, in Brussels we can build a mortar training ground that will enable us to get the Stokes mortar. We will build it. Right, and in Paris we'll get a big caserne. In Rouen we could get a medium caserne there. Bordeaux we can get a small caserne. In Warsaw we can get a small caserne as well. I want to have all the infantry buildings before I do the tanks, I guess. Then the tanks and lastly the planes. I've already built some buildings for planes. previously, so... Because we are in a panic that we would be killed off before my armies from Africa could reach the front. But now they have reached the front, so I'm not worried currently. Even if I manage to delete half the armies, still have the African and Greek armies, the ones from Greece, etc. That will still do well. So we need to go back to Berlin and look at the recruitment. In Oslo we'll get another assault infantry. And in Vienna we'll get another assault infantry as well. In Copenhagen, of course, we'll get another assault infantry. And then we're back in Berlin. We are already constructing Panzer IVs and Panzer Ones in the rest of the cities or planes. Alright, so now it's time to fight battles again. So I think we can start with the battle here against their army. They didn't have a general, but they had quite the force here. Let's start the battle. The balance of power is 3-2 in our favor. Save the game. Save. And fight the battle on the battle map. If only to kick in the door and the whole rotten structure will come crashing down, it'll fit there on the proposed invasion of the Soviet Union. Start deployment. Army is ready. I will just have to group it. Same army that won the last battle. That managed to do quite well. Blitzing the enemy army. Blitzing the tanks and then bombing the infantry when they were helpless. After the tanks had been destroyed. Let's make all these units lose formation, by the way. Forgot that. They will all be lose formation. The infantry will be one group. They can be AI controlled. Start deployment. Oh, there is something there. Farms over there, I see. We had some planes in this army. The infantry will be ordered to attack their infantry. I don't really care. Actually, it doesn't really matter. Maybe we could stop. Let them. We'll take a look at their infantry and order them to take out specific infantry if they have snipers. They had some anti-tank infantry units here. Germany doesn't have any of those. And assault infantry. Riflemen. Do they have snipers? Yeah. This unit will be ordered to take care of their snipers. Actually, I will order them to stop doing whatever they were doing. Then they will take out the snipers there. Sniper versus sniper. How many are they? They are more than us. Let's order the SS infantry to take care of them too. Then we will send the riflemen against the riflemen. So, about the planes. Of course we are going to send our planes against their planes. Fighters against fighters. Okay, three units, we are attacking two currently. More than order to have some the upper hand, but we need to find their final units. Oh, they have better fighter planes. They've gotten their MiG planes. I don't know exactly what they were named. I can't get their info up currently. They are too far away. That's a MiG fighter plane. Their best fighter planes. The Soviet Union doesn't have any bombers. They have two types of fighters. And the Yak 9s are slightly worse than our Messerschmitt 109s, while the new ones here, they are probably equal or better than our fighters. However, when we get our jets, they are better, but that won't happen until 1945, because I don't want to get anything sooner than in real life. So we won't get any jet fighters until late 1945, if we are still alive. And they have already fielded their best fighter plane here. So that's a real threat. So we will send more than one unit against that one. And another one against these. So all our planes are focusing on their planes this time. Our artillery will be ordered to fire at will, just like before. Our infantry are going for their infantry. They have a numerical advantage. Our Panzer Ones will attack their MS Ones there, or whatever they are named. I think it's some MS One or something. We will send both our Panzer One squadrons against them, and then against their T-34 tanks we will send our two units of Panzer IVs, which are slightly better than their tanks. So they have better planes than us, but we have more numerous planes. We will see how this will go. They also have more infantry, but infantry is, as you know, almost worthless. Then we have the BMW motorcycle, of course. I need to send it towards their infantry. It's good against the infantry. So we will avoid their planes, I guess. We'll send it against the infantry over here. BMW motorcycle unit. And then the general's bodyguard will stay at a safe distance. So the army is moving up. Planes have been ordered to blitz the enemy out of the sky. All the tanks are about to take care of their tanks. Our infantry will move against their infantry and the BMW motorcycles. Battle is on in the skies. Let's pause, because I want to know what that is. MiG-3 fighter plane. 230 melee attack 2. Missile attack 32. Total defense 28. Could be compared to their other plane. I want to look at it as well. Just need to find a spot for it. That's not one of them. Need to find one of their older Yak 9 planes there. Messerschmitt has 5 melee attack. Well, they had 2, so the Messerschmitts are better in melee, but they are pretty much not using melee. 37 melee missile, 33 defense. Right, we couldn't click on those for some reason. So, their MiGs, 32 missile, 28 defense. So our planes are better. The Messerschmitt 109 planes are better than their MiGs. Their MiG-3 has 32 attack, 20 missile attack, and 28 total defense. Well, ours have 35, so we have 3 more in missile attack, and also 3 more in defense. So our fighters are better than their best fighter, alright. But their other plane, the Yak 9s, ours were a lot better. Their Yak 9 planes have 0 melee attack, 29 missile attack. They are actually 19 total defense waivers in defense than their other plane. So the Jack 9 are bad compared to other planes, but the MiG 3 is a lot better and than their Jack 9 planes and are almost as good as ours, but they are still weaker, so we have the upper hand in the air, even with the Messerschmitts. So the Soviet Union doesn't have the best fighters, but they still have fielded their best fighter plane now. Alright, and let's continue the battle. That means we have the upper hand in the air battle. We have the numerical advantage and the better fighters. And we should have the upper hand in the tank battle as well. We had more than them. More tanks. More good tanks, etc. We have some MS-1s here. Yeah, they were named MS-1. Oh, I didn't order my Stuka bomber to attack, actually. I forgot about that totally. They will, of course, be sent towards their tanks. I think they are good against tanks. So we will use them to take care of their MS-1 tanks there, unless we can find their T-34s. Here are their T-34s. Let's send them there instead. Battle is going quite well. Let's zoom in on the map. And zoom out slightly. The air battle is quite intense. Planes flying everywhere. So yeah, the enemy has started to build planes as well. If they start to spam planes, I will have no choice but to focus on planes again, but I want the tank army to be true to history. We have already taken out many of their tank armies. Might be too late to have tanks versus tanks only. A good overview here from this hill. Our infantry are moving forward too. Our Stukas have finally reached the battlefield. What are the Stuka stats, by the way? 4 melee attack, better melee attack, 30 missile attack, they have quite good missile attack, they have a different projectile to a bomb. But bad, they have as bad defense as the Jack 9s, alright, 19. No wonder they are easily taken down by other planes. Raging there. Let's see its statistics here. 4% allies killed, 41% enemies killed. Our army were clearly superior. We had way more mechanized stuff than they had. And Panzer IV drew over our troops there. Alright. They seem to already be retreating. Their infantry, most of their infantry are retreating, while the Messerschmitt 109 fighters are firing at them as they retreat. We have won in the sky, not entirely, but we have clear air superiority here, because our planes are firing at their infantry as well, despite being ordered to take care of their planes. So that means their planes are already defeated. Victory! Continue the battle then. Our general is safe distance. I don't want him to die like Gerd von Rundstedt. The game was actually more fun to play when you control the planes and tanks by yourself. It looked good. It was easier than I thought. I thought it would be too annoying because of the huge stretches of the battlefields and the army stretching the entire front, but it was actually quite easy. And I can always put them on AI control if I want to. I will do that with infantry if they break and such, because infantry are almost worthless, unless they are fighting infantry. They have their BMW motorcycles, but they don't have the actual machine gunners. They're probably mostly driving over people. Planes are firing their projectiles as they fly in the sky. The sky is above the battlefield. Guns with the panzers seem to have silenced. And we won, I think. Clear victory. Your army Walter Graf again. Men deployed 405. We killed 676. That was very good. Men remaining 373. Captain Dmitry of the Soviet Union had 791 men. Killed 41. 101 remaining. And the detailed stat sticks. And continue to the map. The assertion that it is the intention of the German Reich to coerce the Austrian state is absurd. Adolf Hitler asserted it's January 1934. But he did actually annex the Austrian state in 1936. So he lied. Or tried to trick people into thinking he had no such plans. Alright, enemy army routes. Enemy army, Walter Graf, another victory. Continue expands, Walter Graf. Yeah. Alright, so we won. We can't move. Usually after a great battle in this game, we can't move. In Medieval 2, we would have been able to move, because he started at this location. But in Rome Total War, it seems if they win great battles, they can't move after. Even if they started at the place of the battle. Let's move the spy. Shit, my mind. She will stay there. Alright, we have another battle to fight. We'll control the army of Gottfried Gillen. The Battle of Brest is about to start. We will save again in case it would crash. And fight the battle. Battle map, and I think about it, what type of city is this, a town, what type of wall do they have, west wall, that's fine, I was afraid they had the wall that is almost impossible to enter. Alright, assault the city. Allow this army to be controlled by the AI. Yes. Fight the battle on the battle map. So they have some good bunkers there. I would say to the house, as I said to those who have joined this government, I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears, and sweat. Winston Churchill, 13th May 1940. Start deployment. We have two armies and the town of Brest is surrounded by the German armies. Alright, start deployment. We have the air force, we have a lot of infantry, we have mechanized troops. They have the bunkers, they will take out some of our mechanized stuff or infantry, I believe. So they took Brest from the rebels. Here they have some custom buildings, by the way. Small casern. This is what a small casern looks like. A building where you can recruit riflemen, etc. riflemen. I think that's the only one. Maybe SLT infantry as well, but I think small Kazan is only riflemen. So this is that building. Looks very good. Some generic houses here. Some farms. Town hall. This is the town hall. Some vanilla buildings that are, I believe they will disappear if you upgrade a certain building. They will probably be replaced later. The custom settlements aren't 100% completed, I believe. They still have some vanilla stuff to take care of. We have the lumber mill here. Custom building. Could be destroyed. All the buildings can be destroyed, but if we destroy the custom buildings, they will lose them on the map as well. In Medieval 2 you can't do that, but in this game you can. So that's a feature I miss in Medieval 2. Yeah, that's a generic building. A windmill here. I don't know if that's a unique thing. I think so too. And our army is located here. I don't like the idea of their bunkers being able to hit my troops from that position. We will move them back. They have quite a range. We will let the AI controlled allied army attack first. They are AI controlled. They will send in all their infantry and their planes. And hopefully the bunkers will take care of their infantry, because they are the least important units to keep in the army. Then I will also send in troops. I should probably send my infantry on a mission to steamroll. We can send the BMW motorcycles as well. They are kind of depleted. And yeah, we will group the infantry as one group there and send them here. They will be, I think they should have a formation too. Alright, they will start like that. BMW motorcycles could also attack. Let's place them under AI control and just click attack. Actually, the almost beaten the aircraft tracks without the actual gun should also be there. Let's move him to the front. And then I think we could actually move the Stokes mortar here and just let it terrorize them. We have two such units. Do they have any? They didn't even have a mortar. I did a mistake, we merged them then. Alright, that means we will send them there as well. And we have another infantry unit there. And they will be placed there. We had quite the infantry force here, stretching the entire front. Alright, let's start the battle and pause, because I need my infantry to attack. Oh, they aren't under AI control. Now attack. Stop your orders and attack again. And as for the Stokes mortars, they could actually help with taking out the bunkers. Stop your actions and attack the bunker instead of terrorizing the city. Alright, and the general will of course use his ability to inspire. There's a Soviet general with a jeep here inside of the town. They have some T T-34 tanks, MS-1 tanks, lots of infantry, more T-34 tanks. Our planes are already inside of the town. Can't attack buildings, only artillery can do that, unfortunately, so neither tanks and or cars or nor planes can attack buildings, only Stokes mortars and West artillery, etc. We had only the Stokes mortar artillery here. They are ordered to take care of the bunker instead, to keep their ability of harming our army to a minimum. Our infantry here is easily entering the city. Their bunkers didn't manage to stop them. The Stuka bombers are terrorizing their troops. And yeah, battle is raging inside of the town. They are attacked from two armies. Here they did do some damage. They made our riflemen rout there. So these units are stupid enough to not do anything. Stop being air controlled then. Just attack their infantry. Attack their infantry, just move into the city or town. Attack! Riflemen and the assault infantry. Right, almost defeated Stokes mortar unit. Two riflemen crews left. They will of course be sacrificed. Our machine gunners are in, and this time they had actual crews with machine guns. They are terrorizing the enemy. Very good. Attack that unit. Battle here is raging. The Allied German army has entered the town with their infantry. SS are firing their assault infantry. Here we have more of them and some snipers. But this is mostly a fight between the planes, as the Soviet Union had some Yak-9 planes in the air defending the city. They had lots of infantry at the center as well. And even some jeeps, bodyguards with machine guns. What are our infantry doing? I ordered them to attack. Actually, stop doing whatever you were doing. Just attack. Attack the infantry. I don't know why they aren't doing anything. We have taken down their bunkers, so now we will order our Stokes mortar to terrorize the city. Some of our infantry did attack and they have retreated. Don't like how the others aren't doing anything. They have a cowardly attitude, just standing outside, waiting on the other army to be defeated first or something. Assault infantry are ready to fire, they are firing their assault rifles. The battle in the sky is raging. Troops are advancing there towards the center. Still have some T-34 tanks here. Fortunately, the bombs of the Stukas can't attack the buildings. But the Stokes mortar will now be terrorizing them. The one I have here. They are firing randomly at their buildings or troops. They are firing at their troops, it would seem. Right, so the battle in the skies are still going on. Planes are having quite the health or hit points, so they are not that easily taken down. Some snipers here firing at them. Their tanks here are all taken down. Some of our planes have been shot down as well. So this is the Battle of Brest. They lost Ivan Konev. Idiot. Attack in the plaza. The general should inspire. So our assault infantry are routing here. Stokes mortars are continuing to fire. Random dead targets there. Firing at will. Still have some riflemen at center. They are being bombed by the Stuka bombers. This is the statistics. We lost 32% of our two armies. That's 64% of one army. And they killed. We have killed 77%. Building lost, building lost, building captured. Right, we captured it, the last one. Lot of our infantry are actually routing on this side of the battlefield. I prefer sacrificing infantry to the bunkers and having them fight over the city than waste my tanks, because the bunkers usually take out the tanks easily. While if they attack infantry, then a lot of them will manage to enter the city. But planes are good against cities. They just fly in and start terrorizing the troops on the ground. Unfortunately, they can't attack the buildings. Because they are not counted as artillery, they are counted as elephants. Here we have some infantry. Here are the Soviet troops. They have some infantry at center still. Some riflemen. Still firing there. They are being shot down by our Messerschmitts and Stukas there. So some of our infantry have routed. Their army is almost defeated now at the center. There's the general, Soviet general. There he died. I think we have won now. Enemy general fallen. Georgi Ivanov dead. So they were easily targeted from the air by our planes. Do they have planes anymore? I don't think so. They have one plane here, still flying. That's why the battle isn't over yet. You might have some units here too. Some riflemen. 14 riflemen here. So we have big losses of infantry here. 5% enemy, the allies killed, 91% enemy, so still a big victory. One of our planes probably got taken down, or if it was their plane, I think it was theirs. That's very good. Only the unit at the center left. And we took the plaza. Seems it's still being fought over. Now we won the battle. Clear victory. Your army, Gottfried Gehlen, had 698 men, killed 257, and have 511 remaining. Captain Reinhold, 492 men, killed 762, that's very good, 255 remaining, we lost half to Ivan Konev, have had 1109 or 1109 men deployed, killed 423, so he killed about half his own numbers, and remaining 60. And the detailed battle statistics. Because we had two armies this time, we had a longer statistics there. Battle results were continue to map. We shall solve this problem, and afterwards Warsaw as the capital and the pool of intelligence of that nation will be destroyed. Heinrich Himmler, August 1944. He spoke about killing the elite of the Polish faction. No, it crashed. I will have to replay this.